150 years ago, the Alexander Dock area was a crossroads of commerce and culture. Just to the southwest of the dock and across the current waterfront drive was Victoria Park, a central meeting place for workers and their families, where they could relax from the daily grind, have a picnic, and play games. Our vision for the development of this area on Waterfront Drive is to create a digital museum and historical memorial to the working people who laid the foundation for Winnipeg's future. We want to make the dock area and the Harbour Masters building a place to rendezvous and remember. The Red and Assiniboine Rivers have always figured prominently in Winnipeg's development as a settlement and then as an urban community. For some time, these rivers were the only transportation route for the early trappers, then a major trade route, and more recently, part of the prairie watershed that sustains agricultural production. The Anson Northrop was the first riverboat to ply the waters of the Red. Soon, other vessels began a thriving transportation industry up to Lake Winnipeg and down to Minnesota and the Dakotas. 24 riverboats worked the river and docked at the end of Alexander Street. Today, the paddle wheel streamers are a memory relived through the cruise boats that dock at the Alexander Docks, providing a unique opportunity to tell stories from this era. Now, over 40,000 people a year take trips along the Red River from this dock. One of Winnipeg's most important historical events was centered in this area. The Winnipeg General Strike happened in part at Victoria Park, the original use of the site. This wrenching episode in Winnipeg's history gave rise to a social movement that brought about justice, recognition of workers' rights, and many of the public services that now are the basis of our quality of life. The James Avenue Pumping Station, which remains in this area, and the city steam plant, which has been demolished, are two significant markers of this contribution to Winnipeg's public history. The story of the origins and functions of these buildings is an interesting one, worth telling. Because of our deep appreciation for our history, Winnipeg has had great success with the development of historical attractions throughout the city. The Forks, the St. Boniface Museum, the Exchange District, and many other museums create substantial tourism revenues and reflect the rich, vibrant history of Winnipeg. Festivals like Folklorama and Festival de Voyageurs showcase and celebrate our plentiful cultural diversity. And the future Human Rights Museum will tell the world's history. And we believe that recognizing Victoria Park could tell part of Winnipeg's cultural history at a site relevant to that past. A place to rendezvous and remember will tell the stories of Winnipeggers who made this important location a vibrant part of our city's commercial and cultural history. This location can become a meeting place again through interactive displays and audiovisual presentations. It can be a place for social and staged events. Rejuvenating this area will augment other historical facilities around the city and contribute to Winnipeg's cultural landscape. Visitors to the west side of the site will enter through an exterior gateway or portal using historical building fragments and walk over a landscaped path of historical discovery and commemoration. There will be a central memorial commemorating the contribution of working people, Aboriginal, immigrant, Métis, men and women, to Winnipeg's history. Visitors coming from the south along a path within Juba Park will be able to enter the memorial and the museum after walking around the building along the deck on the west side or directly from the southwest. Inside the main building will be displays, photos, and video kiosks where visitors can access a bank of recorded stories. The screens could be enclosed in a Stonehenge-like discovery circle with four spokes or segments, each housing a display. A visitor or a group will be able to stand in front of a large 50-inch plasma video screen in the kiosk, similar to a bank machine with a larger screen that would have interactive components. Visitors will be able to select from more than a dozen story themes and modules. This site is a genuine touchstone of historical events that gave rise to Winnipeg's transportation, social, and public works development past. A place to rendezvous and remember will continue and strengthen efforts to develop Waterfront Drive that began with the Forks, then the baseball park, Waterfront Drive itself, and the emerging residential community. This scenic and historically significant location should not be neglected and ignored. The site currently lacks interpretation, but with vision and commitment, it can be a major contributor to what makes Winnipeg a great place to live. The opportunity to share knowledge of the legacy of human rights that were forged on this very site must not be missed.